This looks as if it may have been pre-bought or pre-built, and we're looking at inductive reactance. Did you build this one yourself?
I didn't build this one, Gaz. It was actually in the cupboard with loads and loads of dust on it.
Often good experiments have been used for years and years, and then people don't realise what they do, and then they don't bother getting them out of the cupboard. So just talk me through what I've got here. I recognise some of the bits.
Well, if we have a look at the drawer in here, Gaz, what we've got here is 12-volt AC or DC supply. Supply coming off the positive into a momentary switch, and we have then the supply coming out via here on this junction. We'll do the resistive side. So we've got a 68-ohm resistor in series with a lamp.
And that's all the gubbins we've got behind now. I can see the resistor and I can see the two lamps that are on the drawing. And we've got a giant inductor as well, haven't we?
We certainly have, yeah. On this other branch here, we've got this inductor, which is 3 Henrys, and it'll take 250 milliamp. Same again, 68 ohm resistance, which is then feeding through to the lamp and then returns back to the negative.
Okay, and you're telling me that I'm going to be able to see effectively a back EMF, is that right?
You're going to see what actually happens with the current flow when it actually gets to the lamp.
That's more talking about inductive reactance?
It certainly is, yeah. Okay. It is the inductive reactance of the actual coil in relation to the resistor. So we've got a difference between the resistance and the inductive reactance.
Let's get it up and running. And you said you're going to just put one lamp on for me to start with, is that right?
Yeah, what we'll do is we'll just put the one lamp, which is the resistive part of the circuit. So if I press the switch, as you can see, the lamp comes on.
Okay, yeah, that's a great experiment. Chris, I don't think that's very impressive, is it?
All right, okay, you didn't like that one.
Well, so it's not as good as some of the stuff we've seen. Right, now what's going to happen?
Now what we've got is we're now going to come through the inductor.
And the second lamp goes, okay.
And so, that one works as well, Gaz.
Okay, yeah. So one went through a resistor, one went through an inductor, and now you're going to put both on?
And now we're going to put both on, and hopefully what we're going to see is we're going to see the relationship between the two lamps. If we look very carefully, you'll actually see that the resistive lamp comes on before the inductive lamp.
So what is happening there in the inductive part of the circuit then compared to the purely resistive part of the circuit?
The current is obviously not necessarily going slower, but there's an effect on it of where the current is actually being pushed back.
Would we call that lagging?
We would call that lagging in AC supply, but what we've got there is we've got this magnetic field that's inside this coil is affecting that current flow that's coming through, making it look as if it's flowing slower, but it isn't. It's just lagging behind, like you said.
Incredible. Just brings it to life, doesn't it, when we talk about leading and lagging circuits. To have this experiment, or maybe you'd have to build one yourself, I'm sure somewhere out there you'd be able to get hold of these still. You've got enough details here. It's Irwin, and I'm sure other college lecturers can find it. If not, they can play this video. But some people might be thinking, a number of things. Well, we've got a set of scales back there that aren't blue, that somebody who doesn't like to pull off the cellophane over it. If you want to check out that video, it's on screen now.